और हमारी सर्दियों की कुछ फसलें हैं जो कि तबाह हो गई बिकॉज ऑफ दैट। और इंडस वाटर ट्रीटी के अंदर कोई ऐसी चीज लिखी हुई जिसमें वो बता सके इंडिया को कि पानी की जब सरप्लस होता है, ज्यादा होता है गर्मियों में, तो तब आप उसको स्टोर करें, रन ऑफ द रिवर डैम्स को भी। यहाँ पे आके प्रॉब्लम आया और हमारे हमें वी फेस्ड अबाउट 300 मिलियन डॉलर्स ऑफ लॉसेस बिकॉज ऑफ दैट। और लेकिन हम उस पर कुछ नहीं कर सकते थे, इंडिया को नहीं पकड़ सकते थे, क्योंकि इंडिया ने कहा हमने तो वही वो जो 3.6 मिलियन एकड़ फीट की स्टोरेज थी, हमने तो वही की है। सो सच लैकुनाज आर देयर इन द इंडस वाटर ट्रीटी विच यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड, और इनको आपने इसी तरीके से समझ के इसको आगे लेके चलना। तो इंडिया इज कमिंग अप विद स्मॉलर एंड मीडियम साइज डैम्स। अच्छा, नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द सिचुएशन, वाटर स्कार्सिटी सिचुएशन इन पाकिस्तान। पाकिस्तान इज वन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स ड्राइस्ट कंट्रीज विद एन एवरेज रेनफॉल ऑफ अंडर 240 मिलियन मिलीमीटर ईयर। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, पाकिस्तान इज फेसिंग सीरियस चैलेंजेस, और बहुत सारे एरियाज में पाकिस्तान में जो रेनफॉल है वो उस तरह से नहीं हो रही, पैटर्न्स हैव चेंज्ड, और दी ग्लोबल वार्मिंग एंड सच टाइप ऑफ इश्यूज आर फेसिंग, पाकिस्तान इज फेसिंग। ओवर पॉपुलेशन इज वन ऑफ द कॉज, मिसमैनेजमेंट इज अनदर कॉज, अर्बनाइजेशन इज अनदर कॉज। सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स कलेक्टिवली दे आर इम्पैक्टिंग ऑन पाकिस्तान वाटर स्कार्सिटी। The country's water resources consist mainly of rainfall, rivers, glaciers, and groundwater. And these, Pakistani water, इन्हीं पे हम rely कर रहे हैं। But the population and economy are heavily dependent on the Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias, and Satluj rivers. So we are dependent on these for our consumption, domestic use, or for the economic purposes. Agriculture वगैरह जो है। About 180 billion cubic मीटर्स ऑफ वाटर फ्लोइंग मेनली थ्रू इंडिया। तो हमारा जो पानी है ज्यादातर वो इंडियन कंट्रोल्ड एरिया से आ रहा है, ठीक है, जिसको इंडिया मैनिपुलेट कर सकता है और कर भी रहा है, ठीक है, और आगे भी करेगा वो इसको। तो पाकिस्तान हैज बिकम द वाटर स्कार्स कंट्री इन रिसेंट टाइम्स। लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल दैट व्हेन पाकिस्तान केम इनटू बीइंग इन 1947, एट दैट टाइम Pakistan had 5,000 cubic meters of water available for each person. Today, it has shrunk to 1,000 cubic meters in 2018, which means that we are seriously, seriously facing water scarcity, and it is at it has become at a very, very crucial stage for Pakistan. Now, Pakistan has to take some steps on emergency basis. On war footings to overcome this particular challenge. The issue has been exacerbated by climate change, of course. This the whole world is facing this issue. As I told you before, we are also poorly managing the water resources. Most of the water which is available to us, rainwater or monsoon or flood water, we waste that water. For example, let me give you an example of 2009 and 10 floods. उसके बारे में कहा जाता है कि अगर पाकिस्तान इतना पानी था कि अगर पाकिस्तान उसको स्टोर करता तो मंगला जैसे चार बड़े डैम्स जो थे हमारे वो फिल हो जाते। और लेकिन अनफॉर्चुनेटली हमने वी वेस्टेड दैट, और एवरी ईयर वी डू दैट, और हर साल हमारा बहुत सारा पानी जो है हम वो जाया कर देते हैं। सो ऑफ कोर्स अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इज द लैक ऑफ पोलिटिकल विल। वी आर सेग्रीगेटेड पोलिटिकली। Like for example, on Kalabagh, the Pakhtuns, nationalist parties, they raised this issue that Nowshera डूब जाएगा और ये हो जाएगा और पंजाब जो है वो बिजली ले जाएगा, सिंध को भी यही रोना है कि हमें शेयर नहीं मिलेगा, और वो सिंध कार्ड खेलते रहते हैं। यहाँ तक उनके लीडर्स हैं कुछ, वो कहते हैं जी कि जब बिजली इसमें से निकल जाएगी तो पानी की वैल्यू खत्म हो जाएगी। सो सच टाइप ऑफ पोलिटिकल मोरॉन्स आर देयर एंड हु आर ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट प्रॉब्लम्स फॉर मोर डैम्स। कालाबाग डैम 25-26 साल पहले बन जाना चाहिए था। इस तरह की देर आर मेनी अदर डैम्स विच आर फिजिबिलिटीज आर देयर, बट दे आर स्टिल अंडर डेवलपमेंट, दे आर टेकिंग टाइम टू डेवलप। तो पाकिस्तान इज फेसिंग सीरियस चैलेंजेस। सो एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट 1,000 पे तो था, एंड बाय 2025 इट 1,000 से भी कम हो गए, इट वुड बिकम 700 क्यूबिक मीटर पर कैपिटा, विच मीन्स दैट इट वुड बी अ सीरियस सीरियस चैलेंज फॉर पाकिस्तान। इन 2007 द एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक रिपोर्ट ऑल्सो स्टेटेड दैट पाकिस्तान इज नियरली at water scarcity level, which means that 1,000 cubic meters is the, you know, threshold, and Pakistan has already touched that. And by 2025, it is also going to come down, and then it would become a serious challenge for Pakistan. The economic survey of Pakistan also puts the per capita availability of water in the country at 1066 million per person. So these were few stats which I gave you, and you can put these stats when you are, you know, attempting this question. The gap between water supply and demand is widening, and the reason is simple, that overpopulation is there, mismanagement is there. In 2004, Pakistan's water shortfall was 11 million acre feet, which is expected to grow up to 31 million acre feet by 2025. So this is another study which has, you know, seriously talked about this issue. This clearly shows that Pakistan has become a water scarce country, and in future, the things are, you know, going to get worse if we don't build more dams and we, you know, start managing, you know, water properly. Currently, Pakistan's water requirement in the Indus water system is about 139 million acre feet, while the availability is 139, and there is a gap of about 3.994 million acre feet, which could be filled if we start, you know, smartly using water and water resources, especially save water in the irrigation system at household, use smart taps which, you know, shower the foam only, and avoid, you know, wasting. So we have to change our lifestyle. So this is what it is required in modern times. Pakistan has very little water storage capacity, barely storing 30 days of water in the Indus system, which means that after 30 days, if there are no rains, after 30 days, you know, Pakistan would be facing serious challenge of, you know, water scarcity. So this is the situation we are facing right now. We don't have a storage more than 30 days. Whereas India can store water for about 220 days. This is something very good, you know, good for them. For 6 months, they can store water, which is, you know, for Pakistan, for example, if they want to. So for 6 months, if they store Pakistani water, if they, you know, block Pakistani water, automatically there would be a war between India and Pakistan. And this is the lifeline for Pakistan. Pakistan's economy would, you know, go down. Egypt, for example, another country which has about 700 days of water storage capacity, which is very good. America, for example, they have got about 900 days. So these are the comparisons which are there. And we are at a very lower end. Pakistan shall receive, according to Indus Water Treaty, Pakistan shall receive unrestricted use of all waters of Western rivers, which India is under obligation to let flow. So the Western rivers belongs to Pakistan, and Pakistan can use that water. Article 3, Oblique 1, and shall not permit any interference with these waters. It clearly asks India not to interfere in these waters. So Article 3, Oblique 1 talks about and trying to, you know, put restriction on India that do not interfere these waters and never restrict these waters. So whenever India comes up with any project on Western rivers, India actually violate Article 3, Oblique 1 of, you know, the Indus Water Treaty. They can use it for domestic use, agriculture use, but that is also limited, 3.5 or 3.6 million acre feet only. So these are the technicalities which are there. Article 4-6 of the, you know, Indus Water Treaty also talk about, reinforce that the each party will maintain the natural channels of the waters. They are not going to, you know, divert the channels. For example, India tried to do that when India was coming up with, you know, Kishan Ganga Dam and Buller Barrage. So they were trying to divert Pakistani waters and through a tunnel, which was, you know, automatically was playing with, they were playing with Pakistani flow, you know, Pakistani waters. So the flow of the waters, flow of the river was, you know, they were trying to divert, which definitely would impact on Pakistan. And will avoid as far as, so this is what the Article 4 says, that you are not going to disturb the